Good evening, everybody. My name's Carin Bryans, and I run JP Morgan Chase here in Ireland. Welcome to the evening. I'm really looking forward to it. It's the fourth in the series, the speaker series, which I can't believe it's we're on the fourth one at this stage. Obviously been run by Social Entrepreneurs Ireland. I guess what I wanted to talk about here is really the work that JP Morgan Chase Foundation is taking and the sort of long-term approach that we're taking to support measures to alleviate youth unemployment which in our country, which is something that we've really focused our efforts on in the last couple of years rather than being sort of a scattergun approach to giving and supporting. I think we really wanted to focus in on the area of youth unemployment, and entrepreneurship is a huge part of that. I guess youth unemployment in Ireland has remained stubbornly high, at rising to 28% in September 2013, accounting for around 60,000 young people, despite a lot of initiatives from both the private and the public sector. And many of the sectors in Ireland which traditionally had very high recruitment levels have now drastically cut back. So things like construction down 60% since 2008, and employment levels overall having shrunk by around 15%. JP Morgan has been in Ireland for a long time and is a significant employer here, and we believe that it's critical that we support the communities in which we work, particularly at a time of economic difficulty that we've been going through in the last number of years. And, you know, we focus on financial assistance from the JP Morgan Chase Foundation, which is a very large global foundation, but also, and more importantly, giving some of the time and expertise of our staff here, many of whom are actually in the audience as well. And I think that's often equally as important. Since 2012, we've been supporting measures to enable and develop youth entrepreneurship. And we see that as a key driver of our economy. Wealth and a high majority of jobs are created by small businesses, started by entrepreneurially minded people, and many of those go on to create big businesses. And I think people, from what we've seen anyway, people who are exposed to entrepreneurship frequently say that they have more opportunity to exercise creative freedom, they have higher self-esteem, they have an overall greater sense of control over their own lives. And for many young people in Ireland, entrepreneurship is levelling the playing field and opening up significantly new opportunities. There was a recent Ernst & Young survey in 2013 around job creation, which stated that entrepreneurs continue to be one of the world's greatest sources of sustainable growth, both nationally and within local communities. And the survey reported that young entrepreneurs are optimistic about their future, and they recognise that their businesses have a crucial role in creating employment and tackling the youth unemployment crisis. I think more than 50% say that promoting the role of entrepreneurs in job creation will have a high impact on the growth of entrepreneurship in their countries over the next 3 years. There's another trend emerging that we've been working on as well in the last number of years, and really that is that for many of the new entrepreneurs, the primary objective is to improve the world around them rather than just their own individual and personal prospects. And social enterprise is really about innovation. Entrepreneurs identifying social needs that are not being addressed and devising innovative solutions in an ethical manner, utilising business practices to create a social impact. Many looking for radical solutions to social problems rather than really creating a product or a service that's going to make them personally wealthy. And although the rewards and the prospects of a corporate lifestyle are undisputed, I think working for social enterprise or creating your own opens the possibility of, personally fulfilling opportunities and that many people are starting to realise exist. And I strongly believe that these new entrepreneurs can be the driving force towards a future where sustainability and ethics are at the core of business. So even for the most industrious, and I know we have some very industrious entrepreneurs in the audience today, I think we all know that getting started is not easy. There's plenty of obstacles to overcome, and unfortunately the failure rates can sometimes be quite high. And really that's why we've been delighted to have funded Social Entrepreneurs Ireland, the DCU U Start programme, and now the School for Social Entrepreneurs, which is launching officially today. Three organisations really providing new entrepreneurs in Ireland with the resources and the support that they need to establish and sustain a business idea. We live in a great city, but it's also a local community, and it's been very satisfying for us at JP Morgan to have played a part in developing these three organisations that in turn are helping to create jobs and finding innovative ways of addressing social issues within the local community. So in closing, I'd like to wish good luck to all of the entrepreneurs here today competing for the Minnovation Fund, which we'll be having towards the end of the session today. And I'd like to thank you all for attending, and I'm looking forward to listening to the various speakers and learning what we can do to, to make this an even better place and combine our resources for the good of us all. So thank you very much.